Google has finally introduced a new version of its image generation model, Imagen 4. The previous version, Imagen 3, already did a great job at generating beautiful images. But this one, even better. At the time I'm recording this video, Imagen 4 is available on a platform called Whisk. It might be added to other tools by the time you're watching this, so keep an eye out. Hey friends! Welcome back to another tutorial on Desire channel. Let's dive right in and explore this awesome new tool together. First, open Google and search for Google Whisk. Click on the first result to enter the website. This is the Whisk interface. Just hit Enter to continue, then click Continue and Get Started. We'll be using this platform for today's tutorial. There's also this panel on the left side of the screen. I'll explain it to you at the end of the video. Now let's head over to ChatGPT to help us come up with some cool prompts. I'll search for ChatGPT on Google and click on the first link. This is ChatGPT's interface. I often use this powerful AI in my tutorials to generate prompts. I'm going to ask it for 10 trending image prompts that people are currently using on social media. To make sure it searches the internet, I'll enable the web browsing tool, then hit Generate. And here we go. It just gave me 10 super trendy and creative prompts. I'll copy one of them and go back to Whisk. I'll paste the prompt here. You can also use this button to randomize the prompt, but I'm skipping that for now. From here, you can set the image size. I'm choosing 16:9 landscape. Next, let's go through some important settings. There's a seed section, but I'll leave that as it is. It's mostly used for image locking. Then there's the model section with two options. Best quality, uses Imagen 4. Quality, uses Imagen 3. Let's start with the Imagen 3 model to see how it performs. I'll hit generate and wait. Here it is. A super cute, pastel style image, I really like it. You can click on the images to view them in full or download them. Now let's switch to Imagen 4 and hit generate again to compare. Look at that. This image is noticeably more detailed and beautiful. You can clearly see the improvement in quality. Let's try another prompt. This one has a cyberpunk neon vibe. I'll copy it from ChatGPT, go back to Whisk, paste the prompt, and remove any extra links to avoid errors. Once again, I'm using Imagen 3 for now and hitting generate. Nice. The image looks great, check out the text details. Imagen 3 still does a really good job. You can click download to save the image. Now let's switch to best quality with Imagen 4 and generate the same prompt again. Look at the difference. The lighting, reflections on the water, and shadows are stunning. Even the written text looks cleaner. Imagen 4 is clearly a big step up in this area. Let's try yet another prompt, this time a retro digital art poster. I'll paste it in, leave the settings on Imagen 4 and best quality, then hit generate. Awesome! The poster has a cool, vintage feel with beautifully rendered text. Let's do one more, this time with a lo-fi cozy room style. Hit generate. And here we go, a lovely anime-style room, full of charm and warmth. Now, let's talk about that left-hand panel I mentioned earlier in Whisk. There are three sections. Subject. Scene. Style. You can either write a prompt or upload your own images. For subject, I'll upload a photo of a Dior Sauvage perfume bottle. For scene, I'll upload a scenic background image. For style, I'll type in two keywords, photography and realistic. Then I'll hit generate style, wait a few seconds. And done. Now without changing anything, I'll click generate again to create the final image. The result looks decent, but I feel the scene doesn't quite match the subject. So I'll change it, upload a different scene and try again. Let's erase the previous image, upload a new one, and this time I'll add a more detailed description. I want the perfume bottle in the corner of the image, with soft dust particles floating in the air. The more detailed your prompt, the better your image will be. Clicking generate again. And wow! This time, the image looks amazing. Notice the shadows, reflections on the bottle, and the subtle bokeh effects, I love it. And yes, Whisk shows your full prompt underneath the generated image, which is super helpful. Let's try combining images with ChatGPT too. I'll go to ChatGPT and use the Add Photo or File button. First, I'll upload a city image. Then, I'll upload the perfume bottle again. I'll ask ChatGPT to combine them into an advertising poster. Click Generate and wait a bit. And here it is. ChatGPT did a great job combining the images and even added text, looks fantastic. But remember, image generation in ChatGPT is still limited and takes longer than tools like Whisk. Now let's compare, both tools created beautiful, detailed results, but each has its own strengths. In future videos, I'll show you more ways to generate images using ChatGPT. Even how to create stunning ads with your own photos. If you've watched this far, I'd really appreciate it if you hit that like button and subscribe to the channel. Take care of yourself, and see you next time.